Begin Self-Publishing Episode 131, Quick Guide to Self-Publishing Part 5, Formatting.
Interested in self-publishing but don't know where to start?
Want to get your book onto Amazon?
Want to hold your paperback book in your hands? Learn how on the Begin Self-Publishing Podcast with your host, Tim Lewis.
I'm hoping this will be my penultimate episode of the Quick Guide to Self-Publishing. The last chapter will, of course, be marketing. In this chapter, I'm going to talk about formatting. That's getting your book into a form where it can be stocked for sale on Amazon as an ebook, and Amazon and various other retailers as a print book. So now over to the audiobook. Once you have your book complete and edited, you need to look to get that book into a form where it can be sold as an ebook and potentially as a paperback book or even a hardback book. This last part is what I'm calling formatting in this chapter. Now, how you format a book varies significantly between whether you're talking about the electronic ebook version and whether you're talking about the paperback or print version of the book. The fundamental difference between the two is that ebooks are intended to be read on potentially any device, where for when you're formatting for a print book, you pick a size and then that is what that book is formatted towards. So for example, if you read my Magpies and Magic book on your phone, then that's a much smaller device than if you read it on your iPad or on your Kindle device. So EPUBs have to be much more like a website. In fact, the actual EPUB ebook format is almost exactly like a zipped up website. So a zipped file is just basically a file that contains other files. And the EPUB file format, which is the most used, is more or less just a renamed zip file of a whole collection of web pages representing the chapters of your book. In the simplest level, that's an oversimplification. In terms of what Amazon will take to upload an ebook, they will actually take a Word document or an EPUB file or their own custom mobi and KF8 file formats. The only issue with if you take a Word file and upload it is that you are allowing Amazon to be totally in charge of the conversion process from a Word document to their mobi file format. And that can go wrong at times unless you've got a very simple document. So normally I suggest that you use some kind of tool so that you can inspect the EPUB or mobi file output to make sure that it actually looks correct. Now, the EPUB file format, which I was talking about before, which is the most commonly used and is the international standard for ebooks, is used by virtually every other retailer apart from Amazon. Amazon use their own file format called mobi, though they're moving across to a new one called KF8, which is specifically really designed for Kindle devices. It's not that dissimilar from EPUB, though it's not such an open standard. So if you've got your manuscript, how do you convert it into an EPUB or a mobi file? Well, there are several ways of doing this. A lot depends on where your document is at the moment. If you use Scrivener to write your manuscript like I do, then Scrivener you can set up to compile your document into an EPUB file or into a mobi file directly from the application. Now, this process is not that straightforward. The UI for Scrivener basically gives you 10,000 options, and then it's quite hard to get it right. But once you get it right, it's a great way to easily and quickly produce this EPUB and mobi file that you can upload to Amazon and Apple iBooks and all various aggregator stores, Publish Drive, Streetlib, Drafted Digital, etc. If you don't want to pay for a product like Scrivener, then there are companies like Readzy, which are a solution provider for self-publishers, who have got a free editor process on their website, which you basically type your novel into, or you cut and paste your novel into their editor process, and it will generate an EPUB and a mobi file, and also will also generate print documents for you, but I'll talk about that later. If you're looking for more complicated processing or a more simple experience of doing ebook formatting, then a software package that I've been recommended and I've heard only good things about is a software package called Vellum. Now, Vellum's only available on the Mac at the moment, but it is possible to run it from a PC via a virtual Mac on your desktop. Paul Teague is the person to follow because he has several articles about how you do this. He's a very much a Vellum aficionado. In terms of the simplest solution for creating high quality ebook files and paperback files, Vellum is probably the way to go, but it's a paid product and it's not that cheap. Similarly, if you have experience or you have a free version of something like Adobe InDesign, that can also create ebook files and paperback PDF files. A free program you can use to convert and to check what an EPUB and a mobi file are going to look like on multiple devices is Amazon's Kindle Previewer process, which is available from the KDP website. That will convert a Word document and an EPUB into a mobi file, and it will also show you what the document looks like on various Kindle devices. It's called like a little emulator, basically. So that's a way to check that what you're actually getting created looks okay in terms of an ebook. Now, print is quite a different beast. On print, there is no reflowability. However, print can be quite complicated because there are multiple PDF standards. Now, PDF is print document format and is something created by the company called Adobe and is used basically for every printers or every kind of print thing you can imagine. Now, there are very high quality print formats that some companies like Ingram Spark require that not all programs create. So, for example, the modern versions of Word will let you save your Word file as a PDF file. And that PDF file will work for CreateSpace and or KDP print as it's becoming. But it will not necessarily work for a company like Ingram Spark because you need to have it set up in the correct way for a print ready PDF file. And that's where a program like Vellum or Readsy's Book Editor comes in, because those can generate the correct PDF version for expanded print distribution on a company like Ingram Spark. If you just want your book to be available for purchase as a paperback on Amazon, and you're not too bothered about bookstore distribution, then this is not necessarily that big an issue. But if you are looking for either using Ingram Spark or potentially in the future doing a print run, which is where you provide your print document to a printer and they print off, say, 500 or 1,000 documents, you will need to make sure that you have the correct kind of PDF file. Just saving your document from Word as a PDF file will not create the correct type. So that's something to be aware of. Now, in terms of when you should consider maybe outsourcing the formatting side rather than buying a program or using a free tool like Readsy's Book Editor, if your book is particularly complicated in terms of how you have the text and images, or maybe you've got diagrams, or you want to have a particularly beautiful look as to how your book is formatted. We've all seen like beautifully formatted books. But for your typical fiction or non-fiction book where it's just text and there are no diagrams and no pictures, even something like the Readsy Book Editor or Scrivener will work fine. I suspect even with text images, something like Vellum may be able to cope. And I know that even on Scrivener, you can include images in your document. So you may not need to ever to pay for formatting. But if you do have really complicated needs, like you're trying to do a cookbook or something like that with pictures in it with text overlaid on it, that is where maybe paying somebody on a site like Upwork or even something like Fiverr for generating formatting may make sense, especially if you don't want to have to spend the time to learn a software package to create your own formatted document. You can open a print-ready PDF and look at it on your computer using various Adobe Viewer tools. Check that it looks correct. There are various simple things with books that people get wrong, and I know I've got wrong in the past. Things like changing the headers and footers. There's lots of little details that you can get wrong, and I have got wrong in the past with print books. So there is an argument for saying that if you have the money and you found somebody who's recommended as a print book formatter to get them to format the book for you. But if you have the time to spare to learn a package, especially something like Scrivener that you will be using anyway, or something like Vellum that has really good user-friendly design attributes, then you may be better off, especially if you want to write more than one book, which most of us will do, to actually learn to use one of these packages and actually create your formatted book that way. So that is the world of formatting. In the next chapter, I'm going to talk about the biggest issue for self-publishers in general, which is how to market a book.
Thanks for listening. If you enjoyed today's show, please stop by iTunes and rate and leave a review.
This helps make the show more visible.
For free resources, show notes, and other helpful content, join the community
at beginselfpublishing.com.